Marci Bowers. I'm a physician and surgeon practicing in the suburb of San Francisco, California. So I provide gender affirmation surgery for patients seeking genital reassignment surgery. I've been working with the transgender community since the late 1990s, and specifically doing gender affirming surgeries since 2003. At that time, I took over from a legend in the field, Dr. Stanley Biber, and he himself had actually at one time done two-thirds of all the world's sex reassignments at the time. So I met the facial team first in Bangkok, and I got to critique, or I should say moderate, Dr. Simon's presentation, and was very impressed at not just the quality of the work that was being done, but the heart and the compassion that seemed to be shown for the transgender community. I think it gave us a better appreciation, number one, for what the facial team is doing and how important that work is, seeing how that system ran, how their patients are cared for. But it also gave us ideas and improvements in our own surgical practice, how we can be better, how we can make the experience better for our patients. FFS is being increasingly recognized as being a life-saving procedure for some. That really, the idea of being able to live socially as the desired gender, it cannot be underestimated, and how FFS can impact that. So for people who can't reach the financial means necessary, this kind of idea is giving back in a way that's really, really positive. Facial Team Foundation to help provide care to underserved or very, you know, either impoverished or just socially or psychologically isolated patients in the transgender community that can't access that FFS care otherwise. Well, I'm very impressed with this Trans Health Initiative, and I'm proud to be part of it, because what it's done is it's connected different aspects of gender-affirming care, and also it's provided education to each of those groups, so that we know a little bit about what each other are doing, so that we can often, you know, that we can direct patients to get better care for themselves. Allow doctors to share their knowledge, their experience, even their techniques in a very open way, which is very important for collaboration, very important for transparency about what each of us are doing individually. And it raises the quality for all the transgender community. Facial Team and our center, and the Yesen Center as well, have really had a very nice symbiotic relationship. I think the fact that we provide very high quality, first of all, high quality care, but also very compassionate care. The transgender initiative that the Facial Team organized kind of lays groundwork or lays precedent for the idea of greater collaboration among surgeons and openness towards patients and providers of all sorts. I think that if there is something to be looked forward to in the future, that would be greater community involvement. In other words, not just providing care to patients, but what I'd like to see is maybe invite providers too. Plus, I think that they'll see a greater sensitivity towards patients. I've heard that, you know, when you're not exposed to the transgender community, there's a lot of misunderstanding, lack of information, lack of education, and cultural insensitivity, where patients aren't always treated respectfully, or in terms of their, you know, whether it's pronouns or just how they're treated, if they're really affirmed in the interactions that they have on a day-to-day basis. It's really having exposure and seeing how all of our centers seem to work, the Yesen team, our team, Facial Team, we have that sensitivity, and I'm actually honored to even be included as part of the team. Yeah.